Hi guys, I'm going to show you how you can download WhatsApp GB on your Android phone. It's not that easy to get it from the Play Store because there's so many versions there, you can't really tell. So I'm going to put a link to it in my description so you can easily download it. So let's get right into it. So now I want to talk about some of the key features that are different from WhatsApp. Number one, we have recording status, we have microphone settings, you can schedule a message, auto reply, saving a status, and do not disturb mode. That's DND. Okay, let's download this app right now. Scroll back up. Yep, so once we are up, we're gonna click on download APK so that we can download the WhatsApp GB on our Android phone. One of the things I noticed on this site is that it has a lot of ads on it, and some of them do pop up. Then also, you can also make a mistake and click on them and you're transferred to another site. So you need to be careful when you are on this site. So now we're going to click on go to download page. Once the site opens up, you see download, click on download now. The version we're installing is 14.10 and the size is 49 MB. So that is the size. So one more thing I think, okay. It's not appearing. It says file might be harmful. So what they're gonna do now, you're gonna say download anyway. But sometimes you might have to give permission to the app to able to install on your phone, because Android usually don't allow particular apps from untrusted websites or outside Google Play to be downloaded into the phone. That's because for your safety and security. But most times you can still download some applications and they won't damage your phone, as long you can bear the risks of what could happen if the app is harmful to your phone. Okay, so you can see now it's done installing. So let's open it up. Once you click on open, a sub menu will appear. Okay, this is it. So we're gonna click on package installer. They're gonna click on just once. So it's trying to start the installation, but it says for your security, your phone is not allowed to install unknown apps from this source. So click on settings. So just click on the settings. Okay, so it brings us here. Then I click on allow from this source. So once you do this, you can now go back and install the application, and it's going to work once you do that. So now we're gonna come down and click on install. Once you click on install, the process will start. It takes a couple of few minutes for the app to install on your phone. And that's it, it'll be done. So now you can see it says app installed, and if you look down, you see done, you're gonna see open. What we're gonna do now, we're gonna click on open so that we can start running the app. Okay, so the app is opening up and it looks like the normal WhatsApp. So now it says allow GB to access your photo media files to your device. Click on allow. Then it says allow to access your photo media files again, then click on allow. So once you click on allow, it will have access to your files. So it says here restore, then agree and continue. So we're going to agree and continue. So on top, that's where you put your phone number, then you click next. Then underneath it says, if you want to restore chat history from WhatsApp, make sure you made a backup from your messages, then you can restore it by pressing the button below, then put your number and press next. So we're gonna skip this and just put in our phone number, then click on next. Okay, so right now it's processing. So now it's asking if the phone number is correct. If it's not correct, you can edit it. But if it's correct, just click on OK. So I'm just gonna click on OK now. Okay, right now, so it says to automatically verify with a missed call to your phone. So it wants to verify if this phone number belongs to you. So you can either choose to have a missed call on your phone or get it verified with an SMS. You can also get verified with an SMS sent to your phone with a code. And depending on the version of your phone, this can automatically be read by WhatsApp. So you don't have to type it there yourself. So I'm going to go with verify with SMS. So click on verify with SMS. So this is what I was talking about earlier. So it says, to easily verify your phone number, WhatsApp can automatically detect your verification code if you allow WhatsApp to view your SMS message. So now we're going to click on continue. So now we're going to click on allow so that we can give access to WhatsApp GB to access our message so they can detect the code easily. You can see right now I didn't need to type it. Immediately the code enter, it detected it and filled it into the boxes. So if we use a PIN or security PIN, this is the time you're going to type it into your WhatsApp. If you notice my screen is dark, that is because of the security reasons. That's why my screen is dark, but actually it's not dark. I can see it properly well because I'm screen recording it. Okay, so let's do that now. So right now you're going to allow GB have access to your contacts. Okay, so it says you are using modified WhatsApp version, so unfortunately you cannot use Google Drive backup. So you may be able to use Google Drive backup. And some other things I noticed also is that you won't be able to use your normal WhatsApp once you connect it to WhatsApp GB. So all the messages you have on your other normal WhatsApp, there's a chance you might lose it. Okay, so now this is where you put in your name. You can see it already took my profile picture from my WhatsApp. So now I only need to type in the name. So now I'm going to click on next. After typing in your name, you click on next. So right now it's processing. So right now it says the version of WhatsApp that I have on my phone, it's not up to date. So I need to re-update it. So I'm just going to click on update to update the WhatsApp app on my phone. Or I can just go to Google Play Store and update it from there. So right here, you can see the version on the WhatsApp GB. You can see things that have been fixed and things that are still being added. That's the green one. And the things that have been fixed, is the red one. So let's move it from here. So right here you can see that we are done downloading WhatsApp GB on our phone. So right now you can start using it. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe.